Karl, it's hard on this end to kind of get a sense just of how well, you know, efforts are going, not only to find those who may still be trapped, but also to help those who are still living with food and shelter. How is it going from your vantage point?
Well, I think the Chilean government, on the one hand, has been trying to give this perception that they didn't need help from the outside world, that they had this under control. They had a history of dealing with earthquakes. And what we saw on the ground, particularly from that community of the Chato and also another coastal community that we went to yesterday, they say that they have had little or no aid from the government. That community of Di Chato just today in the afternoon had its first food supplies and drinking water supplies from the government. That's three and a half days after the earthquake struck and after their town was devastated by a tsunami. People on the ground do not think that they're getting supplies quickly enough. In Santiago, the capital, in Concepcion, a different story. But in the outlying areas, the harder hit areas, the coastal areas where most of the deaths were, aid has been very slow getting there, Anderson.
And Karl, in Haiti, we saw hundreds of thousands of people sleeping in the streets in these makeshift tent encampments. Is that the same situation now in the streets in Concepcion and in other towns?
Here in Concepcion, I don't get that sense of flashback. A lot of people are sleeping outside and they're setting up little fires outside, but you don't see them in the great quantities. There are enough structures here in the main city, Concepcion, still standing, that people seem to be absorbed in staying inside. But in the coastal towns where the water, not the earthquake, but the tsunami has done the devastation, there is nowhere to stay. And so once again there, you do see these small tent cities, not on the scale of Haiti, because these are smaller coastal communities. But nevertheless, virtually all the population are living outside. It gets cold here at night. It still is staying dry. And they desperately do need food and especially drinking water, Anderson.